In this video, you'll see a demonstration of a sample application that sends IM text in different formats and a quick walkthrough of the code at the heart of the sample. You'll be looking at video output on two computers, first this computer where the sample's running, and then the laptop that receives the IMs. I'll start off with a demonstration of the sample app. It's open in Visual Studio, and you can see I'm logged into Lync 2013. I'll launch the app and paste in the address I'm sending the IMs to. Select plain text as an option and click the Start button. On the laptop, see the message toast? I'll click the toast and you see the IM text formatted in plain text. Back to the desktop, this time I'll select RTF. On the laptop, see the message text display using RTF. Back to the desktop for a third example, I select HTML. You see it display on the sending computer, and then on the laptop where the message is received, formatted again as HTML. So next, let's quickly take a look at a couple of highlights in the sample code. There are two pieces of code here that give you the best idea of what's happening in this sample. First, the participant added method here creates an iDictionary object called formatted message, which takes the return value of a method called generate formatted message. And you can see that generate formatted message takes the message content as its single parameter. And then second, I'll take you down here and show you the generated formatted message method, which contains a switch block which generates text formatted in whatever way the user selected, HTML, GIF, whatever. So see here the block that handles the HTML selection case. You see HTML text specifying font, color, size. Down here you see the block for the RTF selection case. See it creates a rich text box object and makes all the format settings, red, generic serif, 25 points, and then the font settings and the text are passed in. Some more formatting occurs, and the rich text box object passes the result to the formatted message string variable, which is added to the iDictionary object, which is passed as the return value back to the participant added method where I started your code walkthrough. And the iDictionary object containing the formatted text becomes a parameter for the begin send message method, which starts the process of sending the IM. Finally, you can download this sample application from the developer code samples page on MSDN. To get there, the URL is pretty simple. Just type code.msdn.microsoft.com. And then to find the sample application we're looking at in this video, use the search string link IM, two words. And then in the results page, at the time we recorded this, it was about five entries down.